The Fox and the Ass. An ass, finding a lion's skin, disguised himself in it and ranged about the forest, putting all the beasts in bodily fear. After he'd diverted himself thus for some time, he met a fox, and being desirous to frighten him too, as well as the rest, he leaped at him with some fierceness and endeavoured to imitate the roaring of a lion. "Your humble servant," says the fox, "if you had held your tongue, I might have taken you for a lion, as others did. But now you bray, I know who you are." Application. A man is known by his words, as a tree is by the fruit. And if we would be apprised of the nature and qualities of any one, let him but discourse, and he will speak them to us better than another can describe them. We may therefore perceive from this fable how proper it is for those to hold their tongues who would not discover the shallowness of their understandings. Empty vessels make the greatest sound, and the deepest rivers are most silent. The greatest noise is ever found where there is least depth of water. It's a true observation that those who are the weakest in understanding and most slow of apprehension are generally the most precipitate in uttering their crude conceptions. Grave looks, an aspect of dignity, and a solemn deportment may sometimes deceive even an accurate observer. But wise discourse cannot be successfully counterfeited or assumed, and the sententious blockhead is as easily recognized as the pert coxcomb. It matters not what disguise one of these may assume. He utters himself and undeceives us. He brays and tells the whole company what he is.